Yesterday, the National Unity Platform held a press at its headquarters in Makere Kavule, where they welcomed new members that joined the party. The recruits came from different parts of the country. Among them was the NRM's former Mukono South legislator, Johnson Muyanja Senyonga, former woman MP Mpiji and Sarah Temulanda, among others. NUP's General Secretary Davis Louis Rubongoya also welcomed the members who joined the party through the online registration platform.
Bulirunaku, abantu beyongera kwegata ku National Unity Platform. Mugwanga lyonna lyonna gye tubadde tugenda mu nationwide tour, mubadde mulaba abantu. Enkumi n'enkumi z'abantu.
Chagulanyi cautioned the recruits against going against party principles and asked them to guard against the temptation of money.
Abantu bangi nyo batwega seko ne olubo kubega tako na kubekona.
Later, they commissioned brand new vehicles that are going to be used in the mobilization of their supporters on regional levels across the country. Since the decommissioning of the Chitezi landslide after the tragic landslide, finding an alternative Gape disposal site has remained a puzzle for Kampala Capital City Authority. Yesterday, the KCCA officials held an emergency meeting with the public health facility representatives to come up with an urgent intervention to the problems of garbage litter in the city. This meeting was held at Titante Primary School in Kampala. During the meeting, the KCCA Executive Director Chisaka reported that the authority has to date not acquired a long-term disposal site since the Chitezi tragedy.
Right now we are dumping in Katikolo, in Mukono. We are very grateful to the leadership there. They passed a resolution to allow us. It's a short time. We are hoping that our next solution will work faster so that we move away, because the distance is very far. Fuel is very, very expensive. We need a place where people don't have to travel very far.
Chisaka further asked Kampala residents to locally handle their garbage responsibly. Chisaka also revealed that KCCA has acquired equipment to recycle garbage into thermoelectricity. However, they are seeking a site far away from residential areas to operate. Floods have submerged hundreds of acres of dragon fruit farms in South Vietnam, according to residents. Many villagers were forced to seek shelters on higher ground. The flooding in Binh Thuan province was triggered by heavy rain and the discharge of water from an irrigation reservoir yesterday. Vietnam's dragon fruit exports generated a record $1.8 billion in 2018, but the figure has been declining in recent years. The fiery red and green fruit with a scaly skin that gives its name thrives in hot and dry conditions, but as part of the cactus family cannot stand immersion in water. Yesterday, farmers in two villages in Binh Thuan's Hamai commune said the floods in the area were unprecedented. Around 200 households and 400 acres of crops, mostly dragon fruits, had been flooded, according to a local official in Hamai commune. More than 70 residents moved to higher ground as their homes were temporarily inhabitable. Scientists have warned that extreme weather events globally are becoming more intense and frequent due to climate change.